Follow me. Come on. Stay in here for a minute. I'm gonna radio down and find out what you're doing. Don't touch anything.
Hey. You want a hug? Okay, well, I owe you one for later then. You might not know what's coming, though, but I could just sneak up on you when you're not expecting it.
My dad's never hit me before. Even when I was really bad. He never hit me.
He didn't want to do it, Sarah. Carver made him. He's the bad guy, not your dad. So, in a weird way, Carver's the one that hit you, not your dad.
I guess so. Carver hit me super hard, because it still hurts like crazy.
Yeah, it looked like it.
Well, thanks for trying to help. I don't know why people have to be so mean. Like, even when I'm really mad, I still don't want to hurt anyone.
Don't mess this up.
Yeah, I get it.
Reggie's in charge here, okay? Listen to him carefully.
Yep, no problem, Tavia. Okay, we gotta do a good job, guys. The camp is counting on us. Come on, I'll show you what to do.
It's super easy.
Pick up a pair of those shears. Okay, so we're picking these berries, right? Just pick them, put them in the basket. Simple. While you're at it, if you see any dead branches, take those shears and cut them off and stack them neatly for composting. Got it? Hey, so, is she gonna be okay? 'Cause what happened down there? That was straight fucked up. I don't want her freaking out and getting me in trouble.
I'll take care of her. You don't have to worry.
Good, good. 'Cause I'm awful at that stuff. Look, Bill's had it out for me ever since I helped those guys escape, so I gotta concentrate on my work. That was awkward. I won't do that again. I'm gonna go work now.
Hey. Here, watch me. This isn't that hard, Sarah.
I know, I'm just afraid I'll make a mistake.
It won't be the end of the world if you do. Just keep going.
Oh, shit.
Oh, no.
You didn't do any of your work, Clem.
Just checking in. See how the new girls are working out. Reggie.
Yeah, Bill. Hey.
What the fuck happened in here?
Look, Bill, they're new, and me with my arm, it's just not the easy... I have one arm.
Shut up. Shut the fuck up. You better have an explanation for this. And I mean now.
Bill, please, just...
Sounds like you're about to give me an excuse when I asked for an explanation.
It was my fault. I didn't show Sarah well enough, I guess.
Nah, this ain't your fault. We talked about this, Reggie, didn't we? But you just don't get it, do you?
Get what?
Why don't you girls wait outside? Reggie and I have a few things to talk about.
Thanks for the help, girls.
What's wrong, Sarah? Are you okay?
I gave you plenty of chances!
Please, Bill! No! 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 Please! Ah!
Weakness. Incompetence. It puts us all at risk. And it won't be tolerated. You think about that the next time you're asked to do something. Get downstairs. Bonnie's got some stuff for you to do. Go!
Oh, hey. So, they want you to run some supplies out to the guys working at the expansion? Real simple, just take this over to them. That jacket looks real nice. I don't know what Tavia's talking about. What's wrong? Clem? You all right?
Reggie. Reggie's dead.
What? What are you talking about?
Carver killed him. He pushed him off the roof.
Maybe it was just an accident. Listen to me. Take this stuff out to those guys and come straight back. Just be safe, okay? Now ain't the time to be calling attention to yourself. I need to go find out what happened. Hey, Troy! Clem's just gonna take them boys some nails.
All right.
Go on.
Hey! That ain't your concern. Get that stuff over to them boys. Just follow them cables.
Laborer. Fuck that. Let them do this shit themselves if it's so goddamn important.
Get your fucking hands off
me,
man.
You ain't gonna force me to do this bullshit.
I said get your hands off me.
Or what? You gonna go tell on me?
I'm trying to help you, asshole.
Yeah, this is a real help. Why don't you just worry about yourself?
Get off me.
Reggie's dead. Carver killed him.
What?
You sure? Or did you...
Shit! Fuck! Grab something!
Get up. Get out of there. Come on.
Make me save your ass. Jesus.
Oh, thank God you're okay.
All right, enough mushy shit. You get back inside right fucking now. I'm sure they got shit for you to do in there. Now! Think I'm fucking around? Now I gotta sit down here and babysit you assholes. Can't do a simple fucking patch job without me here cracking the whip? Stop! Hey! It's me!
Luke!
Yes! Man, bit the hell out of me.
Think you drew blood. Come all this way. This is the welcome I get.
What are you doing here?
Alright, listen. We ain't got much time. Okay, I followed y'all here best I could. I haven't had a night's rest since y'all got nabbed. Well, that's the first chance I got to talk to somebody. They're everywhere, okay? They got guards watching everything. Shh. There's a herd of lurkers just south of us. It's bigger than I ever seen around these parts.
Carver mentioned that. Said he hopes it passes us.
Yeah, I heard folks talking about that, but that ain't so. Okay, it's gonna hit this place. I know it is. Now, I don't know when, but it's coming and it's gonna be soon. See, I've been looking for places to get y'all free, but I haven't been able to find anything yet.
Are you feeling okay?
No. No, I mean, yeah, yes. Sorry, I just could use some sleep, you know? Hard to rest when you think a lurker's about to get the jump on you at any moment. But yeah, yeah, I'm fine, okay? Don't worry about me.
It seems dangerous.
Well, the whole situation's dangerous, but, well, we're in it now. That's what we got. We just need a plan and a way to get you and everyone.
Luke!
Oh, sorry, shit. Okay, Troy ain't gonna like you being late. Listen, Clem, I need you to meet me here tomorrow about this time. Because I need you to get me one of those radios, okay? Do you think you can do that? Just one of those walkie-talkies. I just need to be able to tell y'all what's going on with them guards. You know, I'll figure out the schedule the patrols are on. I mean, they're all over the place, but I can keep an eye on them for y'all from out here. Look, we ain't gonna be able to shoot our way out of here, so we gotta be careful.
Okay, I'll get you one.
Thanks, Clem. I'm so glad I can count on you. Remember, you meet me here tomorrow. I'll try and be here around this time, but if I ain't, just wait as long as you can, because I really need one of those radios. And just let everybody know I'm all right, okay? I'm worried they,
Clementine, get out where I can see you.
Go on, get out of here.
The hell were you doing? Huh?
I was hiding from walkers.
Don't go in there, you hear me? That is off fucking limits to you. Bill Radio wants a word with you up in his office. So get on up there, now!
Dude, you better go up and see Bill. He doesn't like to wait. So, you should probably go.
Rebecca!
She's a strong woman, surrounded by weak men. I ain't letting my kid get raised around that. Get in here.
Alvin? Alvin!
He passed out hours ago. He can't hear nothing. No point in making a racket.
Let him go. Please.
Why would I do that? I wouldn't be so concerned about his well-being if I were you. Not with you being so close to the fire yourself. Now. You make sure you tell me the truth when you're sitting where you are, and you won't end up over in that chair. Now, you might not believe this after what happened earlier, but I liked Reggie. He was a funny guy. He kept things light. You need folks like that. It's easy to let depression sink in during times like this. But he was weak. And I don't mean just because he was maimed. That wasn't his problem. He was weak of will and weak of character. And we can't have that around here. Not anymore. Not with what we got at stake.
You're a murderer. You can try and call it something else. But I know what it is. What it really is.
Listen, Clementine. It ain't murder. You see, Reggie put us at risk with his incompetence. He's had a string of screw-ups lately. Killing one in order to save many is part of survival. It's one of the tough decisions that a weaker person couldn't make. It's why it falls to people like us to lead them to safety. You understand? Well, I wish it was different, I do. But they are weak, and we are strong. That's why it's our responsibility to shepherd the flock, to keep them safe. It's their nature to follow, not to lead.
You know what I wish?
What's that, honey?
I wish Kenny had killed you.
And there's all the proof I need right there. You think anyone out there'd have the balls to say something like that? Oh, he did, but look where he landed. And we're more alike than you think. In fact, I think you realize it, but you're not comfortable with it yet. There's no way you could have lasted this long otherwise. I realized it back in that cabin. You were scared, but you looked me straight in the eye, kept your nerve. That's what we need. If we're gonna get through this, the next generation has to be stronger than the last to lead us out of this. Kids like you, raised the right way, the way my child will be raised. It ain't this hurt that keeps me up at night. We can handle that. It's not knowing if I got anyone to hand all this off to, but I ain't worried about that anymore.
It's not your baby, it's Alvin's.
Well, even if that was true, it's mine now. All right, now.
Bill, you there?
Yeah, I'm here.
The loading bay door is jacked. Troy really knocked the shit out of it.
How bad is it?
Rails are tweaked so it won't shut all the way. I don't think it's an emergency or anything, but it's something Stan should take a look at when he can.
I'll get him on it. Out. That fucking idiot. Hurt on its way, and he puts a goddamn ding in my door. Go on back out to the yard. It's almost supper time.
Because we all know what happened this morning. I don't know what that son of a bitch is going to do next.
So you want to ring the dinner bell for a herd of walkers to show up? How is that better?
Because this place will be fucking chaos when that thing hits. No one will be paying any attention to us. And that's when we go. It's our opening. We just got to figure out a way to draw them to us.
Your friend here wants to get us killed by lurkers before Bill can do it.
What is it with you?
That's what it sounds like to me.
You know that's not what he's saying, but it does sound dangerous.
This shit is all dangerous!
Maybe Luke could help us. He's outside. He wants a radio to help keep an eye on the guards.
Thank you. That's the plan I vote for.
You know about Luke?
He flagged us down when Troy wasn't looking. Told us his plan. Mentioned he'd talk to you.
If Luke can tell us what's going on with the guards, we can use that to pick a good time to escape.
That seems reasonable.
Who knows when that'll be? There was a girl back at Crawford that used church bells to send walkers all over the city. We just need something really loud.
The PA system Carver is always using is quite loud.
There's some speakers outside the building, pointed toward the parking lot. I saw them when we were walking out to the work. Troy's always standing next to one of them.
I saw the controls. They're in Carver's office.
She's right. It's all controlled in Bill's office. There's a switch in there that'll turn them on.
How do you know that?
I used to make a lot of the announcements back in the day. I had it flipped on once. Luckily, there wasn't much around at the time to hear it. It was plenty loud, though.
That's perfect. We just gotta get into his office. Why didn't you say something sooner?
Because it doesn't change anything. This isn't a discussion about how to do it. It's a discussion about whether it's stupid. And it's still stupid. The sensible thing is to get Luke the radio and wait for an opening.
You're real difficult to deal with sometimes.
Penny.
No, that's all right. You ain't exactly a peach either.
Why can't we do both? Even if we bring the herd to us, it's probably good for Luke to be able to tell us where they're coming from.
You know what? Fine. I can get behind that. Okay, so we get that turd radio. He keeps us posted on the herd's movement. We fire up the PA thing and bring the walkers to roll over this place.
And then what?
Get some guns and shoot our way out. I don't know. Whatever we can. We improvise.
Then that's not a plan. You don't plan to improvise.
I figured out what your problem is. You don't think this stuff through. If the end of the plan is just to stroll through a herd of walkers, then you should know from the jump there's no way it's ever going to work.
Actually, I do it all the time.
First words I ever hear you say, and it's just some crazy, stupid shit.
Hush. What do you mean exactly?
When you cover yourself in their smell, rub the walker guts all over you. They can't tell you from one of them.
Now I don't know who's crazier.
Trust me, I've walked through herds before. It works. You just have to keep calm and make sure you're good and covered.
I've done it too.
What?
It's how we got out of the Marsh House. Lee covered me and we walked right through.
Really? Holy shit. Oh, good one, Lee. All right, what are we waiting for? Let's get that stupid radio.
We still have to find a way to get in the stockroom.
I got a plan for that, too. Come on, kid. Gonna need your help.
Where the hell'd she come from?
We just need to use the winch. She can just climb up from there. Then, just drop into one of the skylights over the stockroom. There are shelves and stuff for you to land on, so you probably won't fall to your death.
Great. That thing breaks all the time. Unless something's changed, it won't support much weight.
Come on, up and at him.
Don't push her, Kenny.
She's our best bet. I mean that, Clem.
Now or never, I guess.
That's my girl. We gotta get that rope down. Mike, you wanna boost her up?
Come on, kid.
Don't let go.
I got you. They're the sharpest guards in the world, but they're no idiots either. They see you not in your bunk, we're all done. Shit, he's coming back. I gotta let you go. I can't stand here. Grab something.
We're in trouble.
Of them out there.
In the parking lot?
No, not in the parking lot. I can't see them all, but I see the dust they're kicking up.
So you're not sure?
What, about how many there are?
Yeah.
How can I be?
Fuck. I hope they pass by us.
God, yeah. You think we're ready this time?
I don't know. Bill thinks we are.
Of course he does, but he thought the same thing last time.
We learned a lot since last time.
Is it enough, though?
We'll find out if they turn this way.
Yeah. Yeah.
crazy about Reggie, huh?
Yeah.
You think Bill...
Go on.
Nah, it's just... I was wondering if you thought Bill maybe...
Spit it out, Hank.
I don't think Bill was gonna let him back in.
Huh. You don't?
No. Do you?
I don't know. So really, no bullshit. You think we're ready?
I think so. The homestead, at least. I'm not sure about the expansion. They're out there, just moaning.
That's what they do.
It's driving me crazy. It's really unnerving.
I know what you mean. You figure we'd be used to it by now.
I wouldn't figure that.
You never got used to a light buzzing or anything?
A little different when it's dead human beings walking around.
I'll give you that one.
So what are you doing tomorrow?
Bill wants me to start getting this bay door fixed.
Is that why you're down there?
Yep.
What happened to it again?
Troy backed into it when we brought the prisoners, the new people in.
See, it's hard not to call them prisoners.
Anyway, I'm looking at it now. I don't think we have what we need.
Jesus, really?
We repurposed a lot of shit to get this place built. I can't say for sure if we even had the materials before we started expanding.
Get him? Okay, jump down. I got you. We best get in bed. Troy will be back any minute.
Well?
Got him.
Everybody stay where you are. No need drawing suspicion.
That was so cool.
Thank you, Clem.
I told you probably wouldn't die. Nice job.
I was pretty scared.
Nothing wrong with being scared. It's how you handle it that matters. Anyway, get some rest.
I thought about Duck today, about his dumb little face. First things that come to mind are always the dumb things he was doing. Kid was always running in circles. Every damn place he went, he'd just run. He couldn't stop him. Makes it harder to remember he was a good boy. Well, long day tomorrow. One long day.